Saturday, Sunday.
Good morning, WHB. I'm Amanda Shannon.
And I'm Zach Bennett, back with another Period 6 Hurricane Watch.
February break starts today.
You know what February break is for?
Skiing?
No, it's President's Week.
Let's find out what our school presidents know about U.S. presidents.
I'm your host, Logan Rogers.
Hello, I'm Sam, senior class president.
I'm Patricia Dierzius, junior class president.
I'm Anna, the sophomore class president.
I'm Priscilla, the freshman class president.
Let's see what our presidents know about the U.S. presidents. Who was the first president to live in the White House?
Oh, John Adams.
Correct. What president created Obamacare?
Obama.
Correct. Who is the youngest president to serve?
JFK.
Correct. Who is the freshman class president?
Me.
Anna, you're so good.
What number president is currently sitting?
48.
Incorrect.
52.
Nope.
49.
Incorrect.
50.
Nope.
57.
Nope.
53.
Nope.
51.
Nope.
54.
Nope.
47.
Nope.
58.
Nope.
46.
Correct.
What?
Next is a look at one of the things WHB is doing to celebrate Black History Month.
Last week, high school students visited the elementary school to promote diversity.
Here's more about the recent read-alouds.
Last week's read-alouds in the elementary school brought high school students and elementary students together to celebrate diversity. The Equity Committee organized the events as a part of Black History Month celebration. The books chosen are related to the themes promoted by the Equity Committee. High school students read books to a variety of classes and participated in activities with elementary students.
What did you like about having the high schoolers come and read to you today?
I like how to learn about high school before I go to after middle school.
What did you enjoy most about reading to the elementary schoolers?
I enjoyed being able to give some good advice and insight to such young and impressionable kids and tell them like how it's okay to be different than those around you.
The Equity Committee is hoping to have another Read Aloud event in March and April as well.
The friendly face that greets you in the guidance department is retiring.
Ms. Kommer?
Yes. WHB got together to wish her a bittersweet goodbye.
We want to wish a happy retirement to Ms. Kommer. Throughout her 24 years at West Hampton, Ms. Kommer has worked as a teacher's assistant, worked in the computer lab, and currently works as a guidance office secretary. West Hampton Beach will miss you.
Linda, congratulations on your well-deserved retirement. I'm so happy for you, and I look forward to lots more wonderful memories together. I love you, my BFF.
Mrs. Kommer, have a wonderful retirement. We will miss you. Come back and visit us. Peace, my friend.
Oh, Mrs. Kommer, it's been great spending all these years with you. You're really going to be missed. You did an awesome job, and I love seeing your smiling face every day, and I'm really going to miss you. But enjoy retirement.
Bye, Linda. I'm going to miss you. I wish you the best in your retirement.
Groovy Hoovy, I wish you a restful retirement. I will never forget our days in the computer lab together. And I'll see you at the pool.
Hey, Mrs. Kommer. It's been a long, strange trip for the past 25 years. Have a fantastic retirement.
Thank you, Ms. Kommer, for everything you've done for West Hampton Beach. We're going to miss you. But the world is your oyster. Have a great retirement.
Ms. Kommer, I want to say thank you for everything that you've done for West Hampton Beach High School. You will be missed. We love you. We'll miss you. Enjoy retirement. You deserve it.
Happy retirement. Happy travels. We'll miss you. Peace, love, Kommer.
Next up is part two of Justin's Chop Shop, the sandwich challenge.
I've been waiting for this one since the sneak peek from last show.
Yeah, me too. It was pretty heated.
Let's see how it all went down.
Justin, tell us what's on the line today at the sandwich making station.
What I had planned is having you guys make a sandwich, put it together, whoever puts it together the best, cuts the bread the right way, and layers all the components. I feel like we should have a sandwich named after the Hurricane Watch.
right from the start, the bread was all wrong.
I couldn't believe it. Ethan just completely sabotaged me. He stole my lettuce, and I was built to win this competition, so. This was a very serious competition to me, so I had to take my matters into my own hands.
I cheated the whole time.
It ain't a race, y'all. 24 seconds.
Okay, so you were in the lead for a while, and you're doing a great job. Yours has like the sideways thing going on here. Your sandwich is upside down. You were like the late arrival, but I think you did pretty good. It looks pretty nice. You did a great job. We need to have a conversation. Seriously.
Wow, that's humbling.
So taking a bite out of every sandwich, some of them fell apart,
I'm nervous.
Some of them were really good, some of them were ugly, and some of them were pretty, but I would have to say the winner of this challenge was Raquel.
He doesn't even eat a bite yet, you might have a good bite.
So super exciting that Raquel, you are the grand champion of the first annual Justin's Chop Shop sandwich making competition. With the winning prize being, we're gonna name it the Hurricane Watch Sandwich, and Raquel herself will work myself, my chef, to make that sandwich, which will be on our board, and you can thank this young lady for making a beautiful sandwich, okay? So stay tuned to see what she decides to put up on that board. So thank you. High five.
Starting today, faculty and students can get the Hurricane Watch sandwich for just $10 with a bag of chips.
That's almost it for this week.
Let's take a look ahead.
Look out for class ring sales Monday and Tuesday after February break.
Coming up after break is also the Key Club t-shirt contest. Here's more on that.
Key Club is holding a sweatshirt contest for all grades. If you wish to submit your design, a Google form was sent to your email. Your design must represent WHB with a name or symbol. The design should be all-inclusive and the winner will receive a free sweatshirt. You can create your design by using Custom Ink or the Spirit Shop. Congrats again to last year's winners and can't wait to see the designs you submit by March 3rd.
Lastly, the girls' basketball team has a playoff game tonight. Come out and support.
Thanks for watching. Have a great February break. When you dance.